Hello friends, myself Professor Prashant Mahajan, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS Institute of Information Technology. So we have started lectures on fuels. So in the last lecture we have seen Brom calorimeter, its construction, working, calculation and numerical depends on that calculation. So today we are going to see correction formula of Brom calorimeter. So there are some corrections in the Brom calorimeter. So you can see here, for accurate results the following corrections are also incorporated. So first, that is fuse wire correction, that is F. So as magnesium wire is used for ignition, the heat generated by burning of magnesium wire is also included in the gross calorific value. Hence this amount of heat has to be subtracted from the total value. So you can see here we have used magnesium fuse wire. So this is a fuse wire we have used. So that is the heat of that magnesium wire is added to the gross calorific value, that should be subtracted from the total value. Then second, acid correction. So as fuel contains sulfur, nitrogen along with carbon and hydrogen, so on combustion sulfur produces sulfur dioxide and nitrogen produces nitrogen oxides. So if more or excess of oxygen is there, then this sulfur dioxide is going to be converted into sulfur trioxide. And then if we wash that bomb pot with water, then this sulfur trioxide is going to be converted into H2SO4. Same is the case for nitrogen, which is going to be converted into nitric acid. So that formation of acid, it is exothermic reaction. Means what? That formation of acid, that reaction is generating heat and that heat is going to be added into the total value. So that should be subtracted from the total value. So you can see here, during combustion sulfur and nitrogen present in the fuel are oxidized to their corresponding acid under high pressure and temperature. So that part of heat is added to the total value of the GCV and that should be subtracted. So that is acid correction. So the correction must be made for heat liberated in the bomb by formation of H2SO4 and HNO3. The amount of H2SO4 and nitric acid is analyzed by washing of calorimeter. For each ml of 0.1 normal H2SO4 form, 3.6 calories should be subtracted, and for each ml of 0.01 HNO3 form, 1.4243 calories must be subtracted. So this is acid correction. Then next is cooling correction. So as the temperature rise above the room temperature because of cooling, actual rise in temperature is lowered. Therefore cooling correction is to be added in the observed rise in temperature. So cooling correction, it is denoted by Tx, dt or Tc. So T is time taken to cool the water in the calorimeter from the maximum temperature to room temperature in minutes, and dt is rate of cooling. So you can see fuse wire correction, we have to subtract. Acid correction, we have to subtract. And cooling correction, we have to add in the total value. So you can see the formula directly. So gross calorific value is equal to W plus omega, second bracket T2 minus T1 plus dt minus A plus F. So the formula is same, but cooling correction is added and acid correction and fuse wire correction is subtracted from total value divided by X. So this is in the form of calorie per gram. If you want value in the joule per gram, you have to subtract that total value by 4.184 value. So that is the correction formula. Next, numerical based on that correction formula, you can see known CV of fuel. Calculate the GCV of a liquid fuel if the data in the bomb calorimeter experiment is mass of the fuel, that is 1.025 gram. So that is mass of the fuel is X. Then rise in temperature of water is 3.04 degree Celsius. So that is T2 minus T1 is given. Then mass of the water in the calorimeter is W. Then water equivalent is given, that is 770 gram, that is nothing but omega. Then cooling correction is given 0.07 degree Celsius, that is dt or tdt. Acid correction is given 43.9 calorie. Fuse wire correction is given 12.8 calorie. So this is nothing but A value. This is nothing but F value. After putting that all values, again I am explaining, W is given, that is 1900, omega is given 770, T2 minus T1 is given 3.04, then TDT is given 0.07, then A value is given 43.9 calorie, F value is given 12.8 calorie. After putting that value, you will get the answer 8045.8 calorie per gram. So this is the correction formula and numerical based on the correction formula of bomb calorimeter. So this is from today's lecture. Thank you.